Obviously, you're busy fine-tuning your preparations ahead of an all-important quarterfinal. Just how the preparations been going so far?
Preparations, as always, are going good. We are trying to recover the team physically and mentally because we are coming from tough weeks with many situations. From there, I think we started preparing well the game. We still practice twice in the field. Tomorrow we will have the next and the last training. And from there, I think we are going to be more than prepared to face the best team in the last 2 years in this kind of competitions, in knockout competitions, the defending champions, a team that AmaZulu is not beating in the last 13 years. But also we are a team which is doing this season very well in the knockout competitions. We already made history because also in 12 years we were not qualifying for quarterfinals in Nedbank Cup, but now we want to keep making history, and that's going to be the intention after tomorrow.
Coach, coming from a win against Cape Town City in your last PSL game, just how's the mood like at camp?
Of course, when you are winning, the mood is always better, but even when we are not getting the results and we are doing the right thing, I think most of us here are keeping that mood. We try to be balanced, to try to stay calm, knowing that the process is there, that we are doing our best, that you can see the effort and you can see how the team competes every single game, every single minute. So from there, sometimes you understand that this is part of the game, that sometimes we are going to win, sometimes we are going to draw, sometimes we are going to lose, and we take it with naturality and we keep going and working and doing our best to be better and better. So yeah, it's true that when you are winning in weeks like that, or like this one, sorry, also when you are facing this kind of rivals and you are playing this kind of competitions, the excitement is there and the motivation is there. You don't need to do anything as a coach because everyone is looking forward to the game.
Coach, obviously both teams are going to make it to the semi-finals. Just how important is this game and how important is it for AmaZulu to make it to the next spot?
I think it's, in terms of importance, it's the same for both teams. We both want to win, we want to reach the semi-finals. I don't know any team, any coach, any player entering into any game thinking that it's not the most important game of their lives and the only option for them is to win that game. So I think it doesn't make any sense to compare or to say if it's more important for one team or for another. What it's a reality is that we are here in this situation after 12 years, so it's a huge achievement so far for us. But we need to keep being, I think, ambitious and keep dreaming. We know we are going to, as I told you, to play the best team in this kind of competitions in the last years, the defending champions. We are not used to reach this stage in Nedbank Cup for a long time, but from there, no fear at all, and we are going to go with everything, trying to play our best football and try to reach the next stage.
Coach, you speak about Pirates and how good they are in cup competitions, but AmaZulu has also been one of the better sides in South African football when it comes to your good cup side. So do you think the experience that you guys have gained over the years playing in the Carling Knockouts, reaching the semi-finals, do you think that's going to be helpful for you on Saturday?
I think there are going to be pros, there are going to be cons. I don't know if those situations are going to help us, are they going to help them. What I know is that I'm going to see two teams, 22 players at the same time in the pitch fighting for the same objective. From there, let's see who is better, who is controlling better the emotions, because that's going to play a role in the game, not only about tactics, not only about the quality of the players, but about how we are capable of go through with those emotions and control ourselves. That assignment, that crowd, because probably it's going to be the day with more attendance in Moses Mabhida or any other stadium so far this season. So there are things that are going to affect us, not as coaches or football players, but as human beings. So from there it's going to be important, and of course the experience to manage those emotions, the experience to manage the situations that are going to happen and are going to be changing during the game, because both coaches probably will adjust situations during the game, because we know well each other, because we are working during the week trying to look for different solutions or tactics to surprise the opponent. So it's going to be changing, and as it's going to be changing, in the end the ones who have more experience and so they understand better the game are going to be closer to perform.
Coach, obviously on a lighter note, have you spoken to coach at Pirates?
No.
Ahead of this encounter, and obviously knowing him, what can you expect, especially from, he's been there for a long time, but what can you expect from him?
No, I haven't talked to him or to any of the people, staff members or players or even fans from Pirates, and I'm expecting a really tough game. Of course, you are seeing what they've achieved since they are here. They won again for the club championships, they are competing, but they are also a team with weaknesses, like all teams all around the world, and we are trying to be focused on that and how to exploit those weaknesses and take advantage of our strengths. This is football about, that is our tactics, and of course from their side they are doing the same these days in their preparation. So in the end, let's see what happens in the contest.
Coach, Pirates have never lost against AmaZulu. I'm sure you would be very fond of that stats, and Moses Mabhida Stadium specifically. Does that make any difference in terms of your mental preparation, or it's just another statistic?
No, but if you realize what happened so far this season here is that we are breaking many of those stats. In the history of this club, never in 91 years AmaZulu won a cup game away in within 90 minutes, and this season we were capable of beating Chiefs in FMB and then after Sekou Koune. So we are breaking also these statistics, and statistics are there to be broken. And this is what we are going to try to do tomorrow. We already broke the statistic of reaching this quarterfinal. Now we are looking forward to make more history and beat one of the best teams in this league, the best one, as I said, in terms of knockout competitions in the last 2 years. And it's going to be a great game, and if we are getting that, would be a huge achievement for the club, for the fans, and for all of us as technical team and players.
Thank you so much for the